Hey guys, it's Dave from Mind Your Bushcraft. It's been a while since I've made a video, so I thought today would be a good opportunity to do so. It's winter where I live, and the weather's been exceptionally bad, so it's hard to get out. But today I thought I would do a video, had the opportunity to do so, and I've been wanting to make this video for a while. Gotta excuse the mess behind me. I'm in the basement. And this is where I keep my model preps. So it's kind of a mess right now because I'm trying to organize things. You guys can give me some tips and hints and maybe how you guys organize your stuff. I know that sometimes it can be frustrating. So today's video is going to be more of a urban survival than a wilderness survival, mainly because of the material that you're going to be using. It's found more in the city environment. And what we're going to be talking today about is cordage. We all know how important cordage is, whether it be 5-10 paracord or not. Cordage is cordage, and you need it for all sorts of things, whether it be lashing down, a shelter, whether it be fixing a backpack strap, whether it be making, a sling for your arm or a tourniquet. The list is endless when it comes to cordage. And 5-10 paracord is best, in my opinion. Many others, if you can get, if you happen to have that on you and you can use that, that's fantastic. It's got a multitude of uses. Its strength is unmatched. It's great. But if you're in a tight spot and you're in an urban setting and you need cordage and you don't happen to have any standard cordage on you, you can make your own. And the material we're going to be using today are plastic bags. Just bags from the grocery store. These ones are from the old Walmart, and the technique to make cordage out of these bags is actually quite simple. So let's get started. Basically what you want is you want to find the seam. You have this loop here, a handle on the bag, and right in the middle here, on the bottom, is a seam. And see if you can see that in the view or not. You can see the seam right there. So what you want to do is you want to find that seam and take the bag and you want to split it along that seam. And the great thing about this way of doing it, because I've seen others, the great thing about this way is that I don't need scissors, I don't need to use my knife, I don't need anything. And on projects like this, I'd rather not use my bushcraft knife because it's just such a simple thing. And when you're cutting stuff like this, you might get overzealous with your knife and you end up cutting yourself and so on and so forth. This is very simple. Find the seam and it just opens up. It really does. It opens right up for you. You want to go all the way to the bottom. All the way to the bottom of the bag. And do the exact same thing on the other side. Find your hoop, find your seam, split it. Go all the way to the bottom. When you get to the bottom, what you want to do is you want to grab the two handles, okay, put them together, and just kind of go around the bag, stretch it out, make it into a circle. Alright? You got your circle. I'm going to put that down. We're going to grab another bag. Exactly the same thing. Find your handle, find your seam, split it. All the way down to the bottom. Other side, find your handle, find your seam, split it. Now one bag, this is more than 12 inches, obviously. 12 inches is probably going to need more, right about there. So it's just over 12 inches. One bag makes about a foot, right? You can basically say one bag would be a foot. If you're trying to figure out measurements for something in particular that you're doing, it's just easier that way. So that's two bags. We're gonna grab another bag. Again, find the handle, find the seam, and split it. Me repeating myself like this should make all you trolls pretty happy. You guys can make your comments after the video is uploaded. But how I repeat myself. So again, go roundabout, bag rounded. At this point, you've only made one line. I've only used three bags, so you only got about 3 feet, give or take. Okay? So, what you want to do now is you got your hoop, right? You want to grab another bag that you've made, okay? And you want to take one bag, right? One bag, and you want to insert it through the hoop. Okay? Just like that. Now what you want to do is you want to take one end of the bag that's been inserted, right? You want to fold it and bring it through itself. Just like this. Okay? And you want to pull it through. So at this point, what we're doing is we're just connecting the bags, right? We're joining them together. Pull it tight, make a small knot, as small as you can. The tighter you pull, the smaller the knot will get. And then you want to grab one end of the bags, right? Here's your line. Grab one end, open it up, grab the other bag that you previously did. Exact same thing. Put it through the hoop and then bring it through itself. And then tighten it up. Just like that. Tighten it up. You see what you got now? You got some cordage. Alright? Now, this is pretty weak. You could use just this one line, tie something together, whether it be strapping, like I said, a temporary shelter, or maybe fixing a backpack strap. This would probably do a backpack strap, especially if you double it over. But to make this stronger, you want to make more of these strands, okay? I've already gone ahead and I've made two more strands. So I got this one that we just made, right? And I got two more, the exact same length, right? So now we have three strands. And what you want to do is you want to take all three strands, grab the hoops, okay? Kind of put them together to the parallel. All right, one large hoop now, all three bags together. Okay, and I'm gonna dip the camera down for this part. All right, so what you wanna do is keep three bags together, like so. And just put it on your foot. Just put the bags around your foot. Like this. Now you want to separate your three strands. Got hooked here. Separate three strands. Alright, so you got three strands. This part's easy. So now what you want to do is you got your three strands. around your foot. Like so. And all you want to do now is start braiding them. So braiding is fairly easy. If you've never done it, it's take your one side, farther side, and put it over the middle. You take your other farther side and put it over the middle. Take your right side, because I don't want to say farther side again. Take your right side and put it over the middle. Take your left side, put it over the middle. Again, right side, over the middle. Left side, over the middle. And just continuously repeat this process. And all you're doing is braiding the bags, braiding the lines. Continue to do this until you reach the end. Now I'm gonna finish braiding this, and when I'm done, I'll get back to you so I can show you how to connect one line if needed. Just keep putting it over in there. So when you're done, should have about 3 feet worth of cordage. And you can see here how it's braided. Now you get to the end of this and you realize, oops, I need some more cordage. So it's actually fairly simple to connect more to this. What you have is you have your three hoops at the very end where you stuck your foot through so you could braid it. And all you do then is the long process of making more lines. Again, hoop. This one didn't cooperate quite right. So you just make yourself three more lines. I'll try to quickly show you. You make these lines as long as you want, or short as you want. Just for the purpose of the demonstration, I'm only going to use one more bag on each line. Again, like so. Then you take the three hoops you had, and get your three separate hoops. Take one hoop, take your bag you just made, your line, and put it through the hoop, like so, and then put it through itself. All right, and then pull it tight. Now you have an extra line. Next hoop. Next bag, put it through the hoop, like so. A little messed up. Put it through the hoop, and then put it through itself. Tighten it up. Third and last hoop. Your bag. Again. Put it through the hoop. And then put it through itself. Tighten it up. And here's your line. Now you got your three more pieces, three more bags connected, and you can just continue on braiding. Again, right over the middle. When I say middle, I mean the middle line. So you got your three lines. This time we want to go left over the middle, and then right over the middle, left over the middle, right over the middle, left over the middle, and so on and so forth until you reach the end of your line. And then once again, if you need to add more bags to your line, you can do so. It's pretty easy. And you can just continue to do this until you run out of bags. But you can make this line as long as you want. So, once again, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked it and found it helpful, give it a thumbs up. And by all means, leave comments. Let me know what you think. Any suggestions? Any hints? I'm all ears. So, this is Dave from Mind Your Bushcraft. And hope you have a good one. Talk to you next time.